Hey guys, Eric here with RespectedReviews. Today I got the full review of the Macally Amptune dual dock system for your iPhone and iPod Touch. Included in the box is a small and a thin remote control, the AC adapter, a wall charger, and the dock itself. I would like to begin this video just by saying thank you for Macally for sending this out. Let's take a quick look around the product itself. On the front, we have the controls, the back pause, pause and play, forward volume rockers, and the on switch. On the back, we have the 3.5 millimeter jack, and also the DC in or AC adapter port. On the bottom, we have a compartment for batteries, so this does run on batteries. What I really like about this dock is that it's has a lot of little nifty features. For example, it has two 30-pin connectors for both portrait and landscape viewing. It also extends. Another cool feature is that it has rubber feet to protect it from sliding against on slippery surfaces, excuse me. So, also on the front, we have the speaker grills and the Macally logo. The product retails for $60, as I mentioned before, and it has a lot of quality for its price. The sound sounds really well, and its small footprint allows it to be placed anywhere. Also, the batteries, the battery compartment allows you to take it almost anywhere on like traveling trip or camping or something like that. What I also like about this is that you can put virtually almost any iPod or iPhone. The only problem I had is placing my iPod Touch 3G with a case on. It did not fit the 30-pin connector because it has a slightly slanted port on the bottom, so I had trouble doing that and still couldn't put it in, but it worked very well for my iPod Touch 3G with its case on. The pros of this device is small footprint, very high quality sound, and its portability. It's really small and it has battery compartments, allows you to travel with it. The cons, on the other hand, is that it will not work well with a remote. I mean, what I mean is that if you go too far away or if you have from the sides, the remote won't work. And also, if I just take off the power adapter and try to turn it on, it won't work because the batteries have a little juice in it. Not just because a little juice in it, but because it doesn't have enough power to actually turn on from the remote. But if I just plug it in, then it works just quite well. So if those are the cons and pros, it's really good. The sound quality is good, and I'll just show you a little sample in just a few seconds. So I got my iPod Touch sitting on the dock, and it's, you can see it's really sits really well. Doesn't fly off or anything, so that's really good. So right now we'll just take a quick look at a sound sample at full volume, and I'd like to mention that it does a really good job at handling high volume. So here we go. So as you can hear, the sound is exceptional for just a small speaker. That is really good. The bass is not it's really good, but it's not deep enough. But the vocals and the highs and lows are really, really good. So overall, I really enjoy this product. For a $60 price tag, you get a remote control, a lot of portability, really good sound, and also, just get a really nice product. I would definitely recommend it if you're looking for a small and portable speaker dock to go anywhere where you go. And thanks for watching, guys. Be sure to comment, like, and subscribe. And check out my previous videos. Thanks for watching.